From deep in the heart of Texas, it's the Kilroy Show at Willie's Place with your host, Eddie Kilroy. This week's special guest, Susie Dobbs, Ron Williams, and country music legends Charlie Pride and Willie Nelson. Also featuring Mike Seiler and the Mike Seiler Band.
Now Smokey Joe ain't never been rode, Tommy ain't never been thrown. As he settles into the bucket chute, he said, boys, here comes the show. Yeah! It's about to get western round here tonight. Oh, you better wear your working clothes and pull your hat down tight. It's about to get western, I don't mean it, it might. It's about to get western, you can bet your boots that's right. Tommy's spending all his big prize money later on buying drinks at the dance. Making eyes at the rodeo queen, he figures she's worth a chance. Some big bulldogger by the name of Earl says, Tommy, that's my girl. As he ducks and knuckles, old Tommy starts to chuckle, says, all right, let it whirl. It's about to get western round here tonight. How you better wear close, you pull your hat down tight. It's about to get western, I don't mean it, it might. It's about to get western, you can bet your boots that's right. She dragged Big Earl to the pickup truck. Cute cowgirl grabs Tommy by the hand, pulls him to the floor and hollers to the band. It's about to get western round here tonight. Hey, you better wear your working clothes and pull your hat down tight. It's about to get western, I don't mean it, it might. It's about to get western, you can bet your boots that's right. It's about to get western, a cowboy delight. Welcome to Willie's Place.
Susie Dobbs is making anyone who ever told her no, you can't, eat their words. Her career has spanned many disciplines, but music is her true passion and her greatest success. This blonde-haired, blue-eyed beauty proves that country isn't just a genre, it's a way of life.
Susie Dobbs is with us.
All right!
Susie, girl, thank you so much for being here.
You're welcome.
Elizabeth was excited by visiting with you, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to let the girls visit.
Oh. How are you going to do that?
Yeah.
Really? You want to know better.
I don't know girl talk.
You're not going to get a word in edgewise. You know that, don't you?
Susie, I am so happy to see you.
You know what? I am so happy to be in Texas. This is the first time I have been in Texas to sing my little heart out, and
you need to be here.
I know, but
this,
you know what?
Texas,
if I could
need to
have
be.
Picked a long time ago one place that I wanted to do it, first place, it would have been right here.
Absolutely.
Right
you know
here.
What? You know what? Let's talk about something. We both share a couple of common interests.
Yes.
Love of horses.
Oh, yes.
Love of country music.
Oh, yes.
So let's talk about horses. Okay, that's the love of my life, other
you know,
than Kilroy. And we'll,
you better add that. Sometimes.
I have to say, my dad's on the rodeo committee in North Platte, Nebraska. So I was horse crazy as a little girl, and he kind of kept me away from that. And it made me so darn mad, he wouldn't let me rodeo or anything. Now, I kind of thank him, because one, I didn't get mixed up with a cowboy, and two, I started singing.
Singing, my favorite song.
I'd break your heart if you had one.
Oh, I love that song. And we were chatting a little bit about that earlier, and let's talk about that.
You know what, the really, I know I finally made it, because at the National Finals Rodeo last year, there was a group of college rodeo kids, and they were there with the Montana Silversmith people, and Judy Wagner kept saying, just ask her. And I said, ask me what? Can we get your picture taken with us? I said, sure. And they said, well, you won't believe it, but we all sing I'd Break Your Heart If You Had One every time we get our guitars out.
That is
and I was
great.
Like, yes, I finally made it.
That's great.
That's
I was super. So excited.
I love that song. And you'll be singing that song.
Yes, ma'am.
Pretty soon.
Yes,
shortly.
Ma'am. Absolutely. Hello, Willie's Place. You know,
I can't think of a better place to have my first official show in Texas than right here at Willie's Place. I want to thank Mr. Kilroy for bringing me out. And fellas, this is just a warning. When you go around breaking those ladies' hearts, you might be careful. They might write a song just like this one I wrote called I'd Break Your Heart If You Had One. I'd break your heart if you had one. I'd make you cry if I could. It's a waste of time to pay you back for all the things you've done. But I'd break your heart if you had one. When I said I love you, you never said it back. You would walk away like you were just too cool. And when we were together, you always looked for something better. If I could, it's a waste of time to pay you back for all the things you've done. But I'd break your heart if you had one. Oh, now that's country. Down, holding hands and loving someone new, and maybe see a teardrop rolling down your face, but that's something that I'm sure you'll never do. But I'd break your heart if you had one. If I could, it's a waste of time to pay you back for all the things you've done. But I'd break your heart if you had one. What goes around comes around. What goes around comes around. I'd break your heart. Yes, I'd tear it.
Susie Dobbs takes to the stage next, and later, Charlie Pride kisses an angel good morning. Stay with us here on The Kilroy Show.
Hey there, cowboy, where you going to? Has the trail you're on caught up with you? You've always known the dice would roll your way, and if your luck ran out, you could up and ride away. You sit down and
Yes, sir.
How are you, my brother?
Fine, Kilroy. Good
so
to see
good
you.
To have you here.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming in to do the show. Boy, I love your singing, and everybody else does.
Thank you so much.
And we've known each other a long time, and
we
I
have.
Love to visit with old friends.
You
but
bet.
You're not old.
No,
friends
sir.
That I know well.
I'm going to catch you eventually.
I'll tell you what, you have spent so much of your life in the music business.
Yes,
and,
I have.
And raised, of course, and your mother's a dear friend and great entertainer, Leona.
Yes, that's right. Yes.
And here comes Ron Williams just rocking right along.
Well, I, you know, again, just lucky to grow up in a music business family, and mom's such a great writer and a great singer. I would be a fan if I didn't know her.
You well, know? I am so, a fan. But so. Also, that exposed you to so many others.
That's right,
right. You know, you met everyone, you knew everyone from being a child on up to now. I think that's great. And you knew what you were getting into when you got into the
that's right.
entertaining business.
Heck yeah. You know, yes, I was real lucky to grow up around, you know, some of the greatest singers and writers and things all my whole life. And it's natural for me to fall right into that path.
And coming up, you were exposed to so many great entertainers.
Right.
Name me a couple.
Well, There's a fellow named Dave Kirby that I spent nearly 20 years with.
And a dear friend of mine, a great writer.
Stepfather for a number of years, and wrote many, many great songs and played on a lot of hit records. So obviously that influence is there. My mom, Leona, as you mentioned, has written a lot of hit songs.
She
has. Great writer. Of course, there's the Merle thing.
There's the Merle thing.
Yeah,
you were
Merle.
Supposed to.
I was around Merle a lot.
Music.
Yes,
what I want to know is how did you just all of a sudden find your style? Because you don't sound like anybody. So you really were not influenced by anybody.
That's a real good question. Everybody emulates their favorite singers, and mine growing up, Keith Whitley and Marty Robbins, and of course Merle, and the singers, I call them.
Sure.
Country singers out there have a resume of their favorites, and I guess mine probably fall right in line with a lot of singers out there.
Ron Williams is coming up right after this, and still ahead on the Kilroy Show, Charlie Pyatt gets a visit from a surprise guest. You won't want to miss it.
I know you're going to be doing some songs from the new CD.
Yes, I'll be doing several.
You haven't even told me what you're going to do, and I don't care because they're all good. But tell me a story about a particular one that you're going to be doing tonight.
Well, one of the songs I'm going to do tonight, the one and only Bill Anderson is right around, and when I saw the title, I immediately had to listen to this song, but it's called You Should Have More Respect for the Dead. So.
Oh, I love that song. You Should Have More Respect for the Dead.
Yeah,
You're definitely going to do it tonight.
I'm going to do it tonight.
That's a winner. Well, we came here to honky-tonk.
Absolutely.
And you're going to honky-tonk.
This is a place to be.
The greatest pain I'd ever feel was losing you. But lately I've been seeing you with somebody new. It breaks my heart to see another man there in my place. How dare you have that I'm so much in love look on your face. Can you see you're killing me? Your happiness is messing up my head. I've died a thousand times since I threw away your love. You should have more respect for the dead. There ain't no place to run. There ain't no place to hide. A bottle came to battle with my kind of wounded pride. I can't trust your memory when I turn out the light. It crawls in bed beside me and keeps me up all night. Can you see? Killing me. Your happiness is messing up my head. I've died a thousand times since I threw away your love. You should have more respect for the dead. You should have more respect for the dead.
God bless you. Thank you so very much. I appreciate that.
Whenever someone mentions Texas, she gets a faraway look in her eye. Though she's never come out and said it, it's a passion she can't disguise. And lately it's been growing stronger. I feel her slip a little more each day. Her heart belongs to Texas, and no man's gonna stand in her way. Just like an old lover that she can't get over, Texas keeps pulling her home. As sure as the wind blows, some morning I know I wake up and find that she's gone. If I'd lost her love to some cowboy, I think it might be easier to take. But her heart belongs to Texas. She's in love with the Lone Star State.
Here we go.
Just like an old lover that she can't get over, Texas keeps pulling her home. As sure as the wind blows, some morning I know I wake up and find that she's gone. If I'd lost her love to some cowboy, I think it might be easier to take. But her heart belongs to Texas. She's in love with the Lone Star State. Yeah, her heart belongs to Texas. She's in love with the Lone Star State.
Country Music Hall of Famer and living legend Charlie Pride is one of the top 20 best-selling country artists of all time. His incredible legacy includes 36 number one hit singles and over 70 million albums sold. In the history of RCA Records, only Elvis Presley is a bigger seller than Charlie Pride.
Charlie Pride,
yes.
Welcome to the Kilroy Show.
Thank you.
My brother, we've been friends for a long time.
Well, a little while.
Yeah, and I consider this a privilege having you here. Hall of Fame member. How many number one records? Jillion?
No.
It's
30-something.
That's way up there. Everybody wants to see Charlie Pride. I mean, it's a whole deal.
But I'm going to come in here and I come to see Charlie Pride.
Whoa. Horses don't like me.
Mr. Pride, I do, though.
Oh, I'm glad, but don't let it, they don't like me.
My name's Thomas B. Saunders V, and I rode a long ways to come see you. I tell you what, that sweat's been running down the back of my neck like I ain't got nothing on.
It's hot out there, isn't it?
Well, it is. We was raised on your music, and those boys told me out there that I wasn't going to be able to get in here, but I told old Hawkeye we was going to get in here.
That's his name.
That's Hawkeye. Yeah, we got him broke just right before we got in here.
I don't believe that.
Well, there's a lot of people trying to stop us, and I think they kind of, what do they call it, desensitized this horse.
No, they did, didn't they?
Yeah, he's right, control proof now.
Oh.
Good looking horse. Are you on the ride on stage?
No,
or
no,
walk
no,
on?
No, no, I'm going to walk on. He's rode enough.
Well, it's quite an honor to come up here to get to see
you.
And I wasn't going to stop until I got here.
Well, you got in. I couldn't believe I see a horse coming through that door like that.
Charlie Pride performs after the break, and more with Kilroy and Elizabeth here on The Kilroy Show.
Eddie.
Eddie and Liz out on the dance floor. Eddie, how's it looking out there?
It looks great. I'm surrounded by some of the best dancers in the world and some of the best dancers in the Lone Star State. And in the Lone Star State, we know how to dance.
Looking good.
Having a big time, my baby.
Looking good. Looking good.
You bet. I mean, these people are good and they're dancing. I wish I could dance like you guys.
I wish you could dance, period.
Dance, period. That's in one spot.
Yeah, well, any kind of dance. I could dance with somebody.
I'm going to learn dance one day. I'm going to learn dance just like y'all.
Oh.
And then I'll be on TV.
Hey.
Hey, you know what, baby?
What?
Well, hey, one of your favorites is coming on.
Absolutely.
Oh, we love this guy.
Oh, yes, we do.
He and I have been friends for a long, long time, and I'm proud to call him my friend.
Yes, yes, he is our friend.
You know who's coming on
next?
Yes,
I do.
Tell him, baby.
Charlie Pride.
Country Charlie.
Thank you.
Rain dripping off the brim of my hat. Sure is cold today. Here I am walking down 66. Wish she had done me that way. Sweeping under a table in a roadside home. No man could wake up dead. But it sure seemed warmer than it did, even in our king-size bed. Does anybody go at the San Antonio? Our favorite's Arizona. Any place is alright as long as I can forget I've ever known her. Wind whipping down the neck of my shirt. I ain't got nothing on. But I'd rather fight the wind and rain than what I've been fighting at home. Yonder comes a truck with the U.S. mail. Got people writing letters back home. Tomorrow she will probably want me back, but it will be just as gone. Does anybody go at the San Antonio? Or maybe it's Arizona. Any place is alright as long as I can forget I've ever known her. Any place is alright as long as I can forget I've ever known her.
I got to tell you, with all your hit records, with all the acclaim that you've received through the years, including the induction into the Country Music Hall of Fame, there's a long way. It was a long journey all the way to the top that started back in Mississippi and went on to Montana. But the interesting thing, as many years as I've known you and treasured your friendship, I never asked you why you went to Montana.
I went to play baseball. See, baseball plays a real prominent part and how I evolved out of baseball into country music.
Really?
Yeah, you know, I see, that's where I was gonna, I do believe that every kid has a a dream that he'd like to do.
Absolutely.
All right, well, mine was to go to major leagues and break all the records there and set new ones by the time I was 35, 36 years old. Then I would go sing, and then I'd have me some money to go along with it.
There you go.
That was my plan.
Right.
But it didn't go. When they said who hit the most home run, not Babe Ruth and Hank Aaron, Charlie Pride.
Mm-hmm.
So who was the last 400 hitter? Not Ted Williams, Charlie Pride. That was my dream. But I didn't go into country music to try to out-sing anybody. In fact, I didn't even know I was going to be in it. I just happened to be singing it from childhood up until I am now. So, and this old man, this is the truth. My dad used to rent 40 acres from me, of which I went back and bought the 120 acres. Here's what happened. I'd keep going up in baseball, up and going down, come and go down, come back. He said, son, have you ever thought, no matter how good a ball player you are, you're not on this planet to play baseball, you're on this planet to sing. And then he said that, because see, I could run 111 something. I could hit over 300 everywhere I played. I had all three pitches, the hook, hammer, and the change, I mean, the fastball.
Right.
I said, what's he talking about? So before he died, I asked him, I said, why did you say that? He says, On this Spanish thing, he said, "Well, I listened to you. We live about maybe a block. It'll be equivalent to about 2 miles, really. Mm-hmm. And early in the morning, your voice travels on that dew, you know."
Yeah, it does.
He said, "I could pick you out from all the rest of your brothers and sisters."
Singing.
He called me Old Mockingbird. And here's what I believe the reason he called me that. Yeah, but we all sing. All eight boys and three girls, we all sing. I used to go to Four-H Club, and I won Four-H Club contest, you know, imitating animals and the geese going south. Really? Let me see.
Get a gun.
What does that sound like?
Gobbler.
Turkey gobbler?
Oh, well, there you go. That's a good one.
Oh, anyway.
You something else, son?
Well, okay. But anyway, that's why I think he said to call me Old Mockingbird.
Old Mockingbird.
Thank you. So I feel so blue sometimes I wanna die. And so I've got a broken heart, so what? They say that time will heal all wounds in my sense. And I know that someday I'll forget and love again. But just between you and me, I've got my doubts about it. So just between you and me, you're too much to forget. Oh, yeah. So I've lost the only girl I ever loved. And so I've never felt so low, so what? I'll just tell myself this time I wanna cry that someday time will dry the teardrops from my eyes. But just between you and me, so just between you and me, you're too much to forget. You're too much to forget.
Oh, yeah.
There's a lot more Charlie Pride still to come, so don't go anywhere. The Kilroy Show will be right back.
All the crystal chandeliers light up the paintings on your wall. Marble statuettes are standing stately in the hall.
But will the time be proud that has you lighting round after you dry your tears?
When the new wires off of your crystal chandelier.
Never did fit in too well with folks you do. And it's plain to see that the likes of me don't fit with you. So you traded me for the gaiety of the well-to-do. And you turned away from the love I offered you.
Oh, the crystal chandeliers light up the paintings on your wall. Marble statuettes are standing stately in the hall.
But when the time we crowd that happy light and loud, help you dry your tears.
And the new wears off of your crystal chandelier.
See your picture in the news most every day. You're the chosen girl of the social world, so the stories say.
But a paper smile only lasts a while, then it fades away. And the love we knew will come home to you someday. All the crystal chandeliers light up the paintings on your wall. The marble statuettes are standing stately in the hall. But will the time be proud that had you light and loud, if you dry your tears? When the new wires off of your crystal chandelier. When the new wires off of your crystal chandelier.
I hope you never quit singing.
Well, this fella said to me, and it wasn't a lady, it was a fella. He says, Charlie, don't ever stop singing.
I said, well, what are you doing, Ron? He said, well, I'm retired right now. But I said, well, why can't I kind of slow down? No, no, you have to keep singing. I said, well, even if I come out here singing, you got to kiss an angel, good boy. He said, well, if you come out singing, you got to kiss, we'll come out.
So they'd be
applauding. They'd be shaking like that. So that's what I said, okay, I'll think about it.
Well, I can't wait to see your show tonight because it's always wonderful to have you.
I kind of got an idea what I'm doing up there. I mean, this talking to you like that, I don't make the mistake and say the wrong thing.
You never say the wrong thing.
Oh,
we've been
okay.
Friends. And, you know, our mentor, Farron Young,
right now,
would love to see us sitting here talking.
He's watching.
Yeah, he is.
My mother always believed the dead knew what the living was doing. I don't disbelieve that. I say this on stage.
Absolutely.
And I dedicated my autobiography to my mother.
Wonderful.
She used to say to me, now, if I'm the shortest living, don't you go dying because I die. You got a lot to do. So I do this. I say this every night on stage.
Wise words.
Well, she was. She planted a lot of seeds.
And I'm glad your daddy taught you into singing, even though it was lost for the major leagues.
Well, I've had people say, I'm glad you didn't make it. I don't mean no harm.
You went down to...
The Mets.
Texas, didn't you? Not when you were playing, but recently you went down to Texas training camp.
The Rangers, yeah.
Rangers, yeah.
34 years I've been gone.
34 years and you haven't missed it.
Yeah, and I haven't made the club yet either.
Biggest single ever had.
Every odd chance to be old friends on the street. One like how does a man get to be this way? Always got a smiling face anytime and any place. And every time they ask me why, I just smile and say, you got to kiss an angel good morning. Let her know you think about her when you're gone. Kiss an angel good morning and love her like the devil when you get back home. Though people may try to guess the secret of our happiness, but some of them never learn that it's a simple thing. The secret I'm speaking of is a woman and a man in love. And the answer is in this song that I always sing. Like, you got to kiss an angel good morning and let her know you think about her when you're gone. Kiss an angel good morning and love her like the devil when you get back home. Kiss an angel good morning, let her know you think about her when you're gone. Kiss an angel good morning, love her like the devil when you get back home.
Charlie Pride isn't finished yet, so don't go away. The Kilroy Show will be right back.
Heard I was the wooden Indian standing by the door. He fell in love with Indian maid over in Auntie store. Girl, I just stood there and he never let it show. Cause he could never answer yes or no, no. Poor Oklahoma never got a kiss. Poor Oklahoma, he don't know what he missed. Did he any wonder that his face is red? Girl, I just put that a poor old wooden chair. All right now. He always wore his Sunday feathers and he held a little Tommy Hunt. The maiden wore good beads and braided hope someday he taught. And then one day a wealthy customer bought the Indian maid. He took her up so far away he'd open eye to stay. Said he never showed her sign because his heart was made of naughty pine, pine, pine. Poor Oklahoma never got a kiss. Poor Oklahoma, he don't know what he missed. Did he any wonder that his face is red? Lighter than a poor old wooden